Well, but I would also like to see him. I want to kind of see a snapshot of kind of where he goes this season.
Okay.
Take away the breaking in and figuring it out. I want to see now if he's going to go to Europe, demand a price, or obviously MLS is going to demand a price. In MLS, he should be almost a goal a game.
Hmm.
And that's what I'd like to see, if then you could make that jump from the championship, where he went in, did a good job. But where Premier League teams are going to start looking around, they want to see that improvement and that true domination of MLS.
He goes in mid-season, though, to the championship. That's surely not easy to do. Steps into a team, starts scoring goals, gets him into the promotion playoffs. That's got to be worth something to somebody in the Premier League.
At his age of 21, with loads of room to grow, and his numbers are not bad, are they?
They're not bad.
One every two and a bit.
Yes.
He's got the profile for it, doesn't he?
Exactly. Imagine taking someone like him who looks as though he's quick, looks as though he's talented in front of goal.
Is there a passport as well? Because, I mean, that's always key. Obviously, he got to the championship. He wasn't dealing with work permits, so that definitely helps, because the first question I always got from people is, I want to go to England. Okay. Have you played 75% of the last games for the national team? Well, I actually haven't even been called in. Okay, then do you have a European passport? No. Well, there goes that idea.
It was only a couple months' success in the championship. Am I overstating kind of how valuable that is?
No, I'm sitting here when you're talking, I'm listening to the boys, and I'm thinking about Clint Dempsey in New England. And Clint did exactly what Casey was talking about. He had another year. We persuaded him. Because as soon as he knew anybody was interested, he was like, look, I just want to go and play.
Right.
But I think him staying that extra year to mature and actually get to a position where, do you know what? I can't. This is really me. You know, I think DK's not had enough success for a period of time where he's actually 100% confident in himself. Mm. You know, if he goes back to the championship right now and has a struggle, then he might start thinking what you were bringing up. Well, it's only been a good 2 months. You know, you might question yourself, whereas another year of being a superstar, being the man in MLS, scoring goals, then all of a sudden he goes, right, I'm ready. I know I'm ready. Yep. Get me somewhere.
And potentially breaking through with the national team. That's another big part of it, right? That number 9 spot wide open as we look at Jozy Altidore, who's on the preliminary Gold Cup roster. Here we see his numbers with TFC. Of course, we know he's been frozen out of the team. Does Jozy have a future with the U.S. national team, you still think?
Well, give Greg a call, but...
I mean, if he does at this point, it's basically by default, right? It's because Sargent, it's because DK, it's because these guys haven't locked up.
Well, there's no question that the U.S. national team is dying for a number 9 to really stamp his authority on it. Now, Jozy has had his different moments with the national team where he went on a, you know, there were some question marks, and then he went on a great run for Jurgen and scored a bunch of goals in qualifying and put that to bed. And then, unfortunately, at the World Cup, got injured in that first match. Jozy, though, needs to... For me, when you're talking about national team, club always has to come first.
Mm-hmm.
And he's got to sort out that club situation at Toronto and what's going on there. And I know there's been a bunch of rumors about maybe going to Mexico and whatever, but I always feel that play well for your club and then do it for the national team. It's so strange for me. I'm not training even with Toronto. I'm training on my own.
Right.
I'm not playing. But then somehow I'm getting called into the national team.
I mean, what does that say about the national team?
It's backwards.
Well, it's upside down.
Yeah.
It's upside down. Should be. I mean, it shouldn't really even be a question. I'm not sure if I'm the coach of the national team why I would pick a guy who doesn't get a game.
Because you don't have because it clearly says you don't have other options, right?
Or is it a case, Steve, where you say you can come
in? It's not that he can't get a game. It's that he's been frozen out.
Yeah, but you can come in for the national team in a Gold Cup. Score, and then maybe that puts you in the spotlight to get him to Mexico. I know it's backwards and it's upside down. I agree with you 100%.
Another thing is, this guy is not the type of guy who can get away with not playing.
Yeah,
right.
The size he is.
Can anybody?
Some guys can. Some guys can.
Over the last 2 years, he's hardly played.
Yeah, he's got to get fit. Obviously, he has to get fit.
At some point, Seb, you've got to churn out over 25 games a season. You've got to be physically ready to perform for your club and then go on to that next level, which is your country. You can't be playing hardly any games in 2 years and playing for your country.
And we've all known those players. We've all known those players who just, they work so hard. They try to get fit, and then the body breaks down, and they start over again. And, you know, but I agree. Josie's got to get himself fit playing, but it seems upside down that you're going to get that opportunity with the national team to get yourself fit.
If Greg's thinking about bringing him in, that tells you the bad shape the forward line has, these choices.
And also maybe who's available, though, as well for Gold Cup, because we know they've played some games. Other players are going to have to go
fight
for their positioning in their clubs.
It's going to be an MLS roster.
Well, thank you very much for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming, premium content, and let's not forget as well, ESPN FC 7 days a week. Subscribe to ESPN Plus.